Anglo Pacific's highlighted a 127% increase in royalty income as part of their full year results to the end of December. With me in the studio now is Chief Executive Julian Treger. Julian, good morning. Good to see you.
Good to see you again too.
A significant 12 months here for Anglo Pacific, a doubling in royalty income. Most of that down to what's happening at Kestrel?
Mostly Kestrel, but also assisted by the currency movements and lots of good news on other fronts from our royalties, as well as when it comes to the pre-tax level and the post-tax level, fixed overheads and lower taxes.
Dividend-wise, what are you looking at for 2016?
For 2016, we've kept the dividend at 6p, but what's notable is that our dividend cover has grown significantly. Previously, it was just 0.4, and obviously people were concerned about an uncovered dividend, and I'm pleased to say that last year the dividend cover was 1.6 times, which gives us comfort to look at increasing the dividend for 2017.
And indeed, the first time you've achieved dividend cover since 2011.
Yes, it's been pretty much a milestone. Since I joined the company 4 years ago, we've had to battle with much less production from Kestrel and a more difficult mining environment. But I'm pleased to say that we've had income doubling between 2014 and 15, and then doubling again from 2015 to 16. And finally, we're in a much better position.
In terms of Kestrel, 67% of production for 2016 was from your royalty area?
Yes, and that's up from 49% the previous year. And in addition, Kestrel's production rose by 20%, and the coking coal price was much better. So overall, the contribution from Kestrel was vastly improved.
You talked there about the coking coal price. What's your outlook for coal?
Well, we're about to have a cyclone, so we'll have to see what that does to the coal prices in Australia. But generally, it appears that coking coal prices seem to be stabilizing at almost double what they were 12 months ago. And so that gives us a new base from which we can project the earnings for the company. And there are prospects if China puts in place more restrictions on domestic coal production for the price to go much higher.
And importantly, just before we move on, we mentioned 67% of production from Kestrel was from your royalty area. That's by the time we get to the end of this year, you're looking at 90%?
We're looking at 90%, and then we're looking for a number of years when we should be over 90%. And so we have the prospects of 8 or 9 years of very strong income from Kestrel, which will really transform the company and its resources.
So clearly an important part of the portfolio. What's the latest with Narrabri?
Narrabri also did well last year. Production was higher, thermal coal prices were higher, and the currency also helped. And what's very interesting with Narrabri is that the company is moving forward on the development of Narrabri South, which could almost double the size of the area which we get royalties from, and also produce longer long walls for mining, which will increase efficiency. So we're looking forward to good news from Narrabri over the next couple of years as well.
And excitingly, post-period end, the acquisition, your Denison mine acquisition. Just remind us of that.
Well, that was around a $43 million acquisition of the tolling mill fees on a very high quality uranium deposit in Canada. And one of the features of the transaction was that we were owed these fees from the 1st of July last year, which is when we started working on the project. And so I'm pleased to announce that we've received around $3 million Canadian dollars from the Denison transaction in the first quarter of this year, and that will markedly help our results in Q1 and obviously H1 and for the year as a whole.
I like how you described the opportunity, innovative and imaginative. Does this sum up your strategy going forward?
Well, I think we intend to be active and we tend to be creative. I think we're at the second year now of the longer term recovery of the mining sector. We're entering a new cycle. And for the next year or two, it's probably a relatively benign period to be making new investments. So we intend to be active and we tend to be creative and innovative. And we intend to grow the business using largely this significant cash flow we're expecting from our royalty portfolio.
Do you reckon 2017 is going to be an exciting time for Anglo Pacific?
Well, even before we take new steps in terms of acquisitions, and we've already done the Denison one, we were projecting very significant growth again in our income because the coal price is much higher and a lot of new royalties are coming on stream. So I think it will be exciting anyway. And what we're signaling today is that subject to coal price movements, we will look at reviewing the level of dividends upwards with the interims when we have more certainty. So I think for investors, it should be an interesting journey.
Just before we wrap up, probably worth a quick word. You've appointed a new chairman, Patrick Meyer.
Yes.
Tell me a bit more about him.
Well, Patrick has been on the board for a year or two, and he is a veteran both of the city. So he ran the investment banking arm of Royal Bank of Canada, and obviously has very good connections as a result in Canada as well. But more importantly, he specialized in the mining sector for a number of years. And so the combination of his energy and his contacts together, hopefully with my efforts, should result in even better results going forward.
Always good to see you, Julian. Thanks very much.
Thank you for your time.